It is Saturday, November 14th. A lot better than the other days. I am just now, probably about an hour ago, going further and further apart on my coughs without the use of cough drops. So things are looking good. Diarrhea seems to be dissipating as well. I just got this raspy voice. So that's about it. Alyssa and I have just been watching movies. Well, just one movie. We're watching The Stand, Stephen King's movie.
COVID PTSD.
And it's got Alyssa's COVID PTSD flaring up hardcore.
Oh my God, they'd be coughing their heads off at each other.
God wants, I mean, I've been taking showers, but I think once it's all done, I just want to clean this whole room, take a shower, shave, and just go outside. But I don't want to go outside either because that's how you get the fucking virus. So, yeah, maybe just drive around. Yeah, but just trying to make the best of it. But I'm happy that we're doing pretty good. Alyssa seems to be further along than I am, but I'm doing pretty good still. This raspy voice that came out of nowhere. Losing my voice. Did you notice, Alyssa?
Such a bad thing.
Oh, shut up. I just got that. So, yeah, I'll keep. Oh, yeah, tomorrow we got planned to go to Dollar General, get some more stuff. Gotta get the mail and come back. I noticed that if I talk for too long or breathe a little too heavy, I lose short of breath. So, just my coughs have been reduced to that. Just kind of small. So that's about it.
Bullshit, you're not me.
All right. Have a good day. See you later.
Wait a minute, son. Wait a minute. You ain't seen nothing yet.
Positive day. Still doing good. Just this cough. It's the only thing for me. Alyssa doesn't seem to have a cough. Cough. Can't even talk. Still with the raspy throat. Still the same as last time. Just at night when I'm about to go to bed, it seems to be like getting worse. This cough, but it's minor compared to the other few days that, that started off. So we're at least okay. I didn't go anywhere today, but Alyssa went to go get food for us. She's doing good, better than me. She's doing better by going out and about. She still gets a little drained, but it works out. That's about it for now. We've been watching The Stand still. It's a long movie, so. Oh yeah, I didn't even say what the date was. I think it's the third. No, the 15th. Alexa, what's today's date?
It's Sunday, November 15th.
Oh yeah, Sunday, November 15th. Oh well. So, as soon as I get fully at least capable of wandering around without worrying about it, I'm gonna start doing Christmas stuff again and getting Thanksgiving ready. So that's about it. I'll see you guys. It is November 17th. I don't even remember the last time I made a video. I think it was like 2 days ago. We're doing better. Great. It just seems like at night, it gets worse for me. I have these coughing spells that I just want to like die. I'm afraid I'm gonna. And my throat gets sore, but thankfully I have a wife who's with me right now, and she puts a vapor rub on my chest and neck and on my feet. I don't know what it is about the feet, but whatever. It does help, and every day we feel more energized, more ready to do stuff, and then when we do the stuff, it wipes us out pretty quickly. Right now we just went to Fairway. Again, you know, we're masked up. We sanitize our hands. We have these sanitizing wipes for the carts that we carry with us. So we're prepared. We're good. We make sure everybody around us is safe. Although it's still weird. Like, my wife has this PTSD. She sees people without masks or wearing them just under the nose. It's irritating. Because these people don't seem to understand that this Owatonna's in a hot zone right now. And we didn't think we would ever get it. We didn't think we could ever get it. And because we were safe. All I can tell you is it sucks. And we're finally happy that we're getting towards the end of the tunnel of this. And I'm just happy I'm not some statistic of a death chart somewhere. That's my biggest fear is... You hear about it in the news, the statistics, the numbers of the people getting it, and the deaths. And to me, I don't see the numbers, I don't see the charts. I see a human being. Just take one out of the thousands that have died so far. Just take one life. That life was born, was held, raised, fed, loved, taken care of, learned, fell in love, graduated, got a job, had some laughs, shared jokes. This person lived a life. And it was probably too soon for them. You know, like, they should have died in a normal circumstance. Everybody on Earth is entitled to dying in a normal circumstance. But y'all, these freaking idiots, not listening to the rules. That's your choice. These are all your choices. I'm not forcing you. I'm not telling you what to do. I'm not your dad. I'm not your mom. All I can tell you is that this shit sucks. It's your choice. Just try not to make anybody a victim. That's all I'm asking. And if you are somehow contracting this, and even if it's your own reason, I will still send my prayers and thoughts to you, even if you don't think they're worth anything. I don't give a shit. I'm still sending them. Because that's just how we are in this family. And I really hope you guys don't get this because it sucked. But Alyssa's doing better than me. I'd say she's got a little bit more energy. She's further ahead than I am. She's out there right now putting away food. And she's trying to decorate. But still wearing her mask. Still hand sanitized. Because we're still being safe. And thankfully my daughter and my father are in their own rooms. They've been...
Beatrice is like, I sent it. Hopefully it comes back because she has to go back tomorrow.
She always interferes, so I don't know.
Why?
Hold on.
Oh, the video?
The long-awaited Alyssa. She hasn't been in any of the videos.
Yo, don't get the corona. It sucks. I'm still tired, like.
But you're still beautiful.
Especially with this mask.
Sexy.
Putting away groceries on my mask.
Love you. I love you. Alright. But yeah. She's talking about her friend, and Truth is still fucking retarded. They're not requiring anybody to test again afterwards to come back, and they're still asking people to come back even though they're still probably infected. So it's a stupid ass job. So my wife plans on going back next Monday. She is gonna test again regardless, and she's got a note from the doctor for restrictions for the next couple of weeks to work 8 hours only a day, no overtime, and probably like not work too hard because of, you know, over exhaustion. And I plan on going back to work, I think next week, next Monday or something. I don't know specifically. It's really up to my boss. I'm making a longer video on this one because I think I missed a few days and I just want to put it together soon. But yeah, it's and when I go back, hopefully, you know this, Bill, if you're watching this, I'm like ready to go back to work. Like, I'm excited to get out of this four wall bedroom. I mean, that's one. Well, you know, some houses have more. Whatever, you get it. But I'm ready to get the heck back to work. I wish I was gonna be 100% on my first day back, but I most likely won't be. Probably not gonna be able to run too fast or at all, or lift too much. Still coughing if I overexert myself. I'll definitely be wearing my mask and using hand sanitizer. But if none of this is good enough for my job and they tell me, no, you have to stay home, then if you're still coughing, well, then I'm staying home. I'm following rules. That's all I can do. I have been using unemployment. I should be getting my first payment this tomorrow. And if I'm not allowed to come back to work next week, then I'm taking another unemployment week. So I'm still getting paid. It was actually pretty easy to work to fill out, and I really don't care. To be honest, like I said, I'm looking forward to get back to work. It's just this, my health, but and I'm really liking doing these vlog things, vlog, whatever. It's like talking to somebody, but without them interfering and saying stuff. Alright, you guys, I'm out. I'll see you next time.